हेलो वन एंड ऑल प्रेजेंट हियर, दिस इज अमित कुमार सिंह. वेलकम एवरीवन टू माय क्लास ऑन एमएस एक्सेल. इन दिस क्लास आई डिस्कस हाउ वी कैन कस्टमराइज आवर टैब्स इन एमएस एक्सेल. प्रोबेबली आई बिलीव यू ऑल हैव गॉन थ्रू एमएस एक्सेल वर्कबुक प्लेटफॉर्म वेयर एट द टॉप यू सॉ द टाइटल बार, देन यू हैव एड्रेस बार, यू हैव सीन क्विक एक्सेस टूल बार, यू हैव सीन टैब्स. अ लॉट ऑफ टैब्स आर देयर इन एक्सेल. So you can even customize a tab based upon your requirement, filling all possible ribbons, what all require for you. So that all is possible in MS Excel. I'm going to show you and demo how you can do that. So let's begin the class. So here, first let's open MS Excel. I can press open MS Excel window R. Then I can write Excel under run. And then you have Excel opened. So once you have this Excel open, you can see a lot of tabs here: home, insert, page layout, formula, data, review, view. There's a tab called developer tab. So that developer tab normally we use when we work on macros. So you can even make the developer tab visible in case if that is not visible. So you simply go to file, under file, go to options. Okay, under options, go to customize ribbon and tick on developer tab. So if you tick on developer tab and press OK, then you can find developer tab. So once you find the developer tab here, you can do all the required work here. What all work is required, you can work on macros inside the developer tab here. Okay, so what you can do, you can even create a tab of your name if you want. So to go into the file options, the shortcut key for that is Alt FT. So Alt FT, okay. And when you go to Alt FT, go to customize ribbon and click on new tab. If you click on new tab, okay, then rename this tab with anything like Amit Kumar Singh. Okay, you can rename the tab with this name. Press OK. Under this tab, you can create groups. Rename this group like finance. Okay, then you can create one more group called marketing. Rename this with marketing. Press OK. Like that, you can create more groups like this. Maybe operation, you can create groups like this. Okay, so new group here, it is marketing. Press okay. Now you have different groups. Now I have created a tab called Amit Kumar Singh. Under this tab, Amit Kumar Singh, I have groups like finance, marketing, operation. Now what you can do, you can put command under them. Okay, you can put ribbons under them. You can put ribbons under these groups like delete sheet row. Suppose this is a ribbon, put here under finance, insert cell, add this, whatever, insert sheet row, add this. So whatever you feel relevant, font color, add this. So whatever you feel relevant for the finance assignment, all the ribbons you can add inside that. Similarly, you can go into operation group, format painter, add it. So whatever you feel relevant, insert table, you add it. Okay. So all possible ribbons you can add under that group. Similarly, go inside marketing group. Under marketing group, what all you feel relevant, like undo, add this, okay, pay special, add this, okay, then font color, add this. So whatever you feel relevant, you add it, press okay. Now if I press okay, you can see there's a tab called Amit Kumar Singh. Under these tab, you have these groups like finance, marketing, operation. And under these groups, you can see these ribbons. Okay. Clear everyone? You can create this. If you want, I can make all other tab hidden. and only one tab is working called Amit Kumar Singh. So Alt FT. So when I go to Alt FT customize ribbon, if I go to customize ribbon, just untick other ribbons. Just untick other ribbons. What all other ribbons are there? You can just untick them. So I'm just unticking other ribbons. So if I untick other ribbons, there's only one ribbon visible called Amit Kumar Singh. Press OK. Can you see there's one ribbon? There's only one ribbon visible. Now, next time when I'll open MS Excel, then there's only one ribbon visible. There's only one tab visible, not ribbon, called Amit Kumar Singh, which have three groups. So what all are relevant ribbons, all relevant commands, everything I have put inside this tab. Now I don't actually require all other tabs like home, insert, page layout, review, view, formulas and all. Not relevant for me because I've created a tab of my name. And then under that, whichever projects I'm working, I just customized all the ribbons, all the commands under that. So probably now I don't have to depend on any other tabs for my work, and this serves my objective. So this is what, how you can work on. You can actually customize tabs. You can customize ribbons under the tab according to your convenience. If you want to undo this work, go to file, under file, go to option, shortcut keys, Alt FT, customize ribbon, and then do reset all customization and press yes. And press OK. Now all become normal like it was there previously. So I hope you understood what all we had done in this class. So it's time to wind up the class. Thank you, everyone. I'll see you all in next class. Take care. Bye, everyone.